pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Pilliers will now be aboard the Charles de Gaulle.
The Charles de Gaulle, like that background behind us in the previous Star Logs, that was actually the Charles de Gaulle. So everyone got to see the inside of it and what it looks like and what it looks like when you're traveling through space.
Are you in the spaceship the whole time?
Not the whole time, but that is one of the main integral parts of the game that lets you travel through space.
So I love the spaceship, but what about characters? I want to know about that last character that we haven't heard about yet.
Yes, yes. So well, in every Star Log, we've been spotlighting every character, like I mentioned. And there's only one left, right? So we met our character, Fidel. We met Miki, his childhood friend. We met Victor, the honorable soldier. Anne and Emerson as well. And there's only one left, so...
Is the spotlight going to come to life right here in our booth?
Yes, it's the final Star Log. You got to go big, so...
Something special and exclusive.
Yep, I think it's finally time to finish what we started for the first Star Log. Are you guys ready?
I'm ready.
Let's roll it.
What are you doing, Fidel?
Taking a walk.
Maybe I should come along, too.
I'll go with you.
Be my guest. Come on. I've got some stuff to ponder. I want to get my thoughts in order on this walk.
Me too. I'll order my thoughts around while I walk.
Perfect. Then let's be on our way.
Moving.
So, what do you want to do?
Go with you.
But we're heading into the heart of battle.
I'm okay.
That girl's got the guts of someone over three times her age.
Her courage isn't the issue here. I want to know more about me. I want to remember more. Can't do this alone. With your help, though, I know I can. Together, we'll set things right.
Wow. Together, we'll set things right, Kaori.
I hope so on our Star Log, our final Star Log.
Yeah.
So on all of our Star Logs, we collect all of the comments, we read them, and we talk about how we can get all the information out to you guys. And one of the things that we've been getting is the voice actors. Everybody's very curious about who voices what.
Yeah.
So I think we have a special surprise for everybody today regarding voices.
It's just, you're just getting everything today.
Everything.
Voices, character spotlights, trailers. So it's final Star Log. Got to do it. Let's go.
Let's go where?
Let's go roll it.
Oh, new trailer.
Yes.
Okay.
Hi, my name is Tessa Netting, and I play Relia in Star Ocean Integrity and Faithlessness.
My name's Crispin Freeman, and I play the character of Victor Oakville. I know your skills are formidable, but do not let your guard down.
Like, what you see is what you get, and I think that Victor Oakville is a lot like that as well. He's not one for subterfuge. He's not the sort of scheming Machiavellian character. He tends to wear his heart on his sleeve.
My name is Eden Regal, and I play Miki Sylvester. She cares so deeply about the people in her life and the people that she meets. She sticks up for them. She's loyal. She's a lot of things that I would like to be, personally, and I enjoyed exploring that side of myself through her.
I play Emerson, and my name is Christopher Corey Smith. Emerson is a rogue. He is a hero, but he's also kind of an anti-hero. Sort of, kind of respects authority, but he also is going to do his own thing. He's going to utilize his own judgment. He's going to make his own calls. That was the best part, was seeing where he started and where I was able to take him.
My name is Amae Castle, and I play Fiore Brunelli.
Fiore Brunelli. You can just call me Fiore.
She is this amazing signeturge who has these magical powers. She is a bombshell. She knows exactly what she wants, and she's really into researching everything that she possibly can about magic and being an expert at the top of her game.
Keep that underlying principle in mind. is Erica Luttrell, and I play Anne. I was intrigued by Anne because she's incredibly ethical, incredibly intelligent, and incredibly tough.
I'm Max Middleman. I play Fidel Camus.
I teach swordsmanship in the village of Stahl.
He's courageous, he's got humility. I think most importantly, he cares about the people around him and the people who are closest to him. That's what makes him such a three-dimensional character. I think this Star Ocean is in line with the compelling narratives that the other Star Ocean games had, and I'm looking forward to playing it myself.
It's a timeless story where these friends are helping each other, going on a journey and starting in one place and ending in another. And I think video games that tell stories are the best kind. It's more than just fighting or more than just playing. You're in this story and in this world and in this universe, and it's really special.
Outer space is so full of mystery.
I knew that was the only choice I could make.
Ethereal Blast!
Arcadia!
Divine Wrath!
Discoveries truly do await us around every corner.
That was great. Everyone, please help us welcome our very special guest, Tessa Netting.
Yay!
Oh, yes.
Hi, guys!
Hello! She is
Thank you for having me.
Thank
you for coming.
Yeah, is this your very first E3?
Yes, this is my first time here. It's so exciting. It's so cool. I'm just so excited to be here. I was playing the game earlier.
Yes, we played
it. It was so fun. And I took the quiz and I got Relia.
She really did.
I will show you the picture.
Yeah. And you still got Relia.
She did.
Wow.
It was meant to be. It was meant to be. Mm-hmm. And I'm just so excited to be here and to be a part of this game.
Thank you so much for taking the quiz. So she came by the booth. She played the game. She's actually pretty, pretty good.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it was fun.
I was very surprised. But we do have a Star Ocean quiz. And for those who haven't played it yet, it's on our Star Ocean Facebook page. So find out which character you are like most. But before we begin, for those that don't know you, do you want to tell everybody a little bit about yourself?
Sure. My name is Tessa Netting. I'm an actress and a YouTuber. Right now, I'm on a Disney Channel show called Bunked, where I play Hazel, and that's very fun. And my YouTube channel is called youtube.com/TessaRocks, TessaRoxx, and I talk about all the geeky things that I love, like Harry Potter.
Lovely. You are a busy lady. Thank you for coming all the way over here today.
Of course.
Yeah. So, Tessa, as you might know, Star Ocean has a pretty large fan base.
Yes.
And we actually took to Facebook to kind of ask our fans what they wanted to ask you, because they know you're the voice of Relia, and they wanna get to know you more, so they want to ask you questions. So
okay.
We took to Twitter and Facebook, and we took some questions from them, and we want to ask you them.
Okay, great.
Cool.
Let's do it.
So the first question, at Star Bridget asks, what was this experience like compared to film or theater?
Well, for theater, film, and voice acting, it's all about taking a character and bringing it to life. Mm. But in film and theater, you have your body to tell the story, not just your voice. But with video games especially, you really have to focus on making sure that your voice not only portrays like emotions, but also like movement and physicality that you can't really see, that you just have to portray. So it's kind of challenging, but it's really fun. And also, if you want, you can come in your pajamas.
What?
So you can, no, like, no, no.
Yeah. You can wear like whatever you want when you record. Yeah. So I think it's pretty fun.
That's so interesting. Especially we saw that a little bit in the trailer where you like, you know, you have to experience the magic of it while you're doing it, or else it wouldn't be believable.
Right.
You know?
Right.
So the thing is, she's so animated. Like when you're seeing her, you can see her like moving and jumping like little Relia, but then in her voice, she conveys all that through like that's the visuals. So
right.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Cool. So next question. James Potter with two A's.
Oh, nice!
Wow.
Oh, like Harry Potter.
Yeah, Harry Potter fan. What is your favorite thing about your character?
That is so hard because I really do love Relia so much. But my favorite thing would probably have to be
her connection and the love that she has for all of her friends, especially mm-hmm. Fidel and Miki. They have a really special connection, and when I was voicing her, I really felt that, and mm-hmm. I felt that was really special because it's just like that bond sort of holds the whole game together. Yeah. So
wow, she's kind of like a main character of the story. It's
yeah, it really cool. It is.
Everyone's
yeah,
trying to like save
like
her.
Protect me. Everyone, cute. Look out for me. Yeah, yes. Her, Relia, Relia, Fidel, Miki, I'd say they're like the core nucleus
right.
that
exactly.
makes up the new story for
yes.
Star Ocean.
Right.
So yeah. Next question. Do you
okay.
want to take this one? Kiari?
Me? Okay. Sure. So at XPUKL. L6 asks, in what way do you relate to Relia?
Well, both.
You look older than you're 12, right?
Yes,
right,
I'm 12? Not 12.
Okay,
I'm older than 12. I'm
okay.
twice that. But,
okay.
but both me and Relia, we're both pretty small. We're very small, but we're mighty. So
mighty.
People
yes.
underestimate us because of our size, and they think that we're very weak, but we're strong mm-hmm. and powerful. So I feel like that's how I relate to her the most. People underestimate us, but then we come back and we show them that we can fight too.
Dynamite.
Yeah.
Small package. Pack in the heat. Cool.
Exactly.
So we have another question.
Yeah.
You want to take
this one? 36TDR5 asks, how would you say this character shares your personality?
I think both Relia and I, we can be very shy at first when we, especially when we make new friends, but when we become friends with a person, then we really open up and we're very talkative and we ask a lot of questions and we can be a little annoying, but in like a cute, adorable way, I hope.
Cute. Thank you.
So I really resonated with her with that sort of like shy at first, but then really opening up later.
So does that mean we're friends now? Because you've been pretty friendly
yeah.
with us and talkative.
No,
so
we're besties.
Officially
yeah.
besties.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're all BFFs now.
Yeah,
yeah.
definitely. Yeah.
Okay, cool.
And so guys, I have to ask, mm-hmm. I've been watching all the previous Star Logs.
What?
And yes, I have. And one of the main things that you guys do mm-hmm. is you share exclusive content. But since this is the last one, like, what else do you have to share?
Mr. Exclusive. Do we have exclusives for her to
I
share?
I mean, yes. We wouldn't be the last Starlog without more things to share,
oh.
without a few surprises. I think it's awesome that you watch all the Starlogs
Thank
first.
You.
Yes,
yeah.
of course.
But yeah,
they're nervous on there.
Oh no,
on the
Starlogs. You guys are great. You guys are great. We're besties.
Oh, okay,
we're besties, guys.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right.
So yes, there are a few surprises left, and I just think with you being here and like the gravity of the character you play, I think it would just be an honor for us to have you announce
it.
Yeah, present the next trailer.
I would love to. I would love
okay.
to. So, for every fan of the series, old and new, I hope you all enjoy the launch trailer for Star Ocean: Integrity and Faithlessness.
My whole world's changed.
Can something so wondrous exist here? You've seen firsthand how persistent those reprobates can be. Really is so significant to them that they're willing to go through all of this for her.
Now get that loser kid to surrender Relia to us!
That all you can muster? Get out of my way, you worthless cretin!
So many were killed. Here on out, I won't allow any people to hurt you.
I should say that, not you.
It's okay. I'm tired of this.
I promised that I'd protect you. If you left me behind, I wouldn't be able to live with myself.
Surely you understand the consequences of this.
What would you do in my shoes? If it meant possibly throwing everything away and never coming home?
Return victorious.
Let's go.
Lead the way, my brethren of the blade.
Very cool.
Wow.
Right? The stars await you all. Thank you, Tessa, for doing the honors. That was great.
Of course.
And second, I wanted to ask, did you like the trailer? What did you think of it?
Yes, I loved it. The buildup was so intense.
And
so
your backpack?
It's the music,
yes,
right?
Yes, that's so cute. We'll oh, she's so one. Cute. Oh, yeah. I love a backpack.
She's very good.
I think the buildup is also about the music. I don't think it's been said enough, but Motoi Sakuraba is the composer for it, and he just... You know, you hear it in every trailer. His music is really awesome, and it just creates that sense of, like, it just creates a better ambience to the trailers that you wouldn't get anywhere else. So,
right.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you can also really see the relationship between Relia and Fidel and Miki.
Right.
That sort of, like, that core nucleus that we were talking about, that friendship that really drives the whole story. It's so important, and as a voice actress, it was really challenging to do that, but it was fun.
You did a good job. We didn't talk about the villains, but I think we saw a villain in there, right? The
yes.
main villain for the first
yes.
time.
Yes.
We
did.
Can we bring a shot of?
Yeah, we did catch a glimpse of General Alma, who is the main villain of the story. And look at him; he just looks. his face just screams evil. I think, right?
Yeah. What can you tell us about General Alma? Like, I know nothing of him right now.
Yeah, so General Alma, he's obviously, he just looks evil, but also he's after Aurelia, as you saw from the trailer. But I think what you don't really see about him or hear about him is that he's a very ambitious person, and that comes into play when, for the reason why he's after Aurelia and things like that, so...
Yeah, and you can also see, like, by the way that he talks to our heroes, that he just thinks that he's better than them. He thinks that he's above them all.
Yeah, he's really bad news, and our heroes will definitely be tested. The trailer does touch upon a few of the main themes of the game, and sacrifice is definitely one of them. Relia, you do say in the trailer that your whole world has changed.
Yeah.
And Fioria does mention in there that she's never going to be able to come home.
Mm-hmm.
And Miki mentions that people are dying, and there are many things along that subject that you'll encounter while you're playing the game, so everybody is going to pretty much be tested.
Yeah.
I don't believe I'm actually about to say this, but it's almost time to wrap everything up for the final Starlog. And it just feels so... Tessa just joined us. Like, she could have been for Starlog 5.
And
stop.
It's been a good run, a long run, a good one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So 7 years since the last Star Ocean, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I'm really excited for this new era to start. And there's so much potential with this game. I really am excited that Kobayashi-san contributed to all of this reboot. And Akiman as well as an artist. Sakuraba-san, as you mentioned, with Trace went all out. And I just want to thank the development team for all of their hard work.
Yeah.
And for me, as a voice actress, having a character like Relia, who the audience can really connect to and grow with, it was so important to me to make sure that she was done right. So being able to portray a character like her, it was such an honor. It was just to be a part of this franchise. It's amazing. It's incredible. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and I'm so lucky that I got to be a part of it.
Right? Yeah. I to echo what you said, for me... For me, it's really about the 20th anniversary of Star Ocean.
Right.
It's this year, and it just made sense to make a new Star Ocean game for fans of the game.
Yeah.
They've been waiting 7 years, like you said.
Yeah.
And I've been reading I read all the comments on the Facebook page, all the Twitter comments on the Facebook page to see what you're all talking about and what you want and what you want to hear about. And it's just been really like a positive vibe from everybody. They're excited for a new Star Ocean game. And I just want to echo that we're all excited here, too. That's why we bring you these shows, to make sure that you're informed and keep you hyped up, because the game is worth it, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah. That being said, I think it would not be a final Starlog without one last surprise to share with y'all. Yeah. That being said, that's what we're all about. So... on top of that, we asked one of the most asked questions for the past week, past month, past couple months has been, when can I pre-order this on PSN?
Right.
Digital,
yes. When can we all order this on PSN, and what do we get from it? And the answer is today.
Like today. Right now?
Right now. If you log into your PSN,
right now.
You can go on PSN and pre-order the game.
And what do you get? When they pre-order, do they get anything special?
Yes, they do. They get very special things. You can get the everything from the Day 1 edition. So that's all the DLC from the Day 1 edition. It's 7 pieces of the DLC.
Even the Bushy Broom?
Even the Bushy Broom.
That's a cute character.
Yes. That's a little character on your little backpack.
On your backpack.
Oh, yes. So cute. And I have one last thing to add. In addition to all of that, the players who pre-order will also receive this dynamic theme.
A dynamic theme?
Yeah. So who does it feature? Oh, there's Fidel.
Ooh, Fidel.
He's in Resulia.
Resulia.
Wow. And so you can see like little, you can see his little hair flapping in the wind.
His little hair flapping.
His hair's flapping
his
in the wind.
Blue hair.
Sorry. Oh, and there's Miki.
There's Miki.
There's a windmill spinning.
Ooh. Yep. and she's like waving. She's about to cast a spell on you guys.
Oh. She's cool.
Yeah.
I love Miki.
Miki in that stall, that's
she's
her hometown.
Like big sister mode.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
And there you are in the Charles Dinkle.
Tessa, you're in space.
I'm in space.
Tessa's in space.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
She's cool.
She's very cute.
So that's you can pre-order now. You can get that theme. You can get all the DLC, and you can all do that today. So
amazing.
One last surprise for everybody. You're in. Yeah.
And
what
before
else
we sign off, I want Erikso, Mr. Eso right here.
Yeah, he's been
to
here.
Do like one quick giveaway before we're off air.
Yep.
Hi guys, I'm just doing a cameo for today. so as some of you in chat have noticed, we've started the raffle. So all you need to do is type exclamation mark raffle within chat, and we'll be announcing the winners real
soon. Of lithographs and
of the
strategy
and we have
guide.
The collector's edition strategy guide.
Yeah. So make sure you get that strategy guide to help you beat the game. And the lithographs are just, they're very limited, so make sure you enter.
He said there's only 100, and he promises that. So I'm going to check his desk on Monday. If he's lying, I'm going to send them to you all.
I think that is going to do it.
Thank you so
That's
much,
it.
Tessa. Wow. That was so much fun.
Thank you so much for having
Tessa,
me.
Tessa, thank you for joining us. It was awesome.
It was so much fun.
Yeah. That being said,
we're signing off.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.